The oceans of the world are places of beauty and majesty. But did you know that the ocean's waves are one of the most powerful forces of nature? Hi, I'm Danielle with ExploreOcean. We've all seen the terrible and destructive images of the tsunamis that have hit Japan and Indonesia over the last few years. But even normal waves have an amazing amount of power in each and every one of them. In fact, waves generated by fierce winter storms can have as much total water in them as an Olympic-sized swimming pool when they break in locations even thousands of miles away. And that's just one tiny section of it. Waves are generated when wind blows across the surface of the water. As this happens, the energy of the wind is transferred to the water in that the surface becomes uneven and raises and lowers with the wind. The harder the wind blows, and the longer it goes for, the bigger the wave gets, as even more energy is transferred to the wave. Just down the street from ExploreOcean is one of the most unique waves in the world at a surf spot called the Wedge. Paolo Prieto is a pro skimboarder and three-time world champ, and Paolo knows the Wedge inside and out, literally.
Yes, the Wedge is my favorite place to skim because of the size, shape, and power of the waves here. You can catch the best wave of your life on any given day here.
What makes the wave work the way it does?
Well, waves bend and refract as they approach the shore. As they approach the shore, waves bounce against the jetty or reflect. If the timing's right, the bounced wave off the jetty will connect up with a second wave and form a mega wave that is 2 to 3 times the size of what it originally would be.
You mentioned the word refraction and said it was like bending the wave. What do you mean by that?
Well, a lot of people don't know this, but the energy of a wave goes way deeper than what you see on the surface. Even smaller waves can go as deep as 50 feet. As the wave energy runs into shallow waters, it slows down. As the shallower part slows and the deep part continues at the same speed, the wave bends in shape and changes direction, which is called refraction. The Wedge is pretty special in that the bottom contours seem to be perfect for making this happen. There really isn't anywhere else in the world like the Wedge.
So Paolo, why don't we see regular surfboards out there very often?
You will see regular surfboards out there, but not as often because it's such a dangerous place. It's very difficult to surf, and so for the average surfer, it just really may not be that fun. Too dangerous. In addition, the average surfer will probably break a lot of boards here, so you better have a big quiver if you plan on surfing the Wedge regularly.
Paolo, thanks for sharing one of your favorite breaks with us as we educate and inspire people of all ages to explore the ocean, the Earth's last great frontier.